Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte appeals to communist rebels not to intercept any delivery of COVID-19 vaccines. He wants the Communist Party of the Philippines to guarantee that all vaccines will be delivered unhampered, especially in remote areas.
May I just address myself to every government worker? Lahat tayo, like us, also a government worker. Do not delay and do not hinder or obstruct the smooth flow na nakikita ninyo ngayon. From the time of the arrival to the time of clearance, hindi naman kayo ano. Well, of course, maybe ang trabaho lang ninyo, customs, is magtingin. Well, you have no business na buksan-buksan yan dyan. You're not allowed to do that. I am not allowing you anybody there sa airport na magbukas-bukas. Allow the vaccines to be transported freely and safely. I am asking you now to observe that rule because that is for the Filipino people.
The more infectious UK variant from the coronavirus that emerged from China last year has claimed its first victim in the Philippines. The country's health authorities meanwhile admit they mistakenly identified a COVID-19 case in Cebu province as having been infected with this variant. Rafael Busano has this story.
The Philippines records its first fatality due to the UK COVID-19 variant. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergara says the agency is now looking into how the patient was infected.
The person is an 84-year-old from La Trinidad, Benguet. Died sometime in January, 3rd or 4th week of January. Apparently, nung kausap natin yung regional office namin, they said that this person never went out, no? Seldom. Pero hindi talaga, nandun lang daw sa loob ng bahay, walang ibang contact. So tinitignan ho natin ano kung ano po yung source of infection at ano pa yung ibang circumstances.
Out of the country's 25 UK variant cases, 22 have already recovered and only 2 cases remain active. Most of the cases are from Bontoc Mountain Province and La Trinidad Benguet, which is why the local government passed an ordinance for the strict wearing of face masks and shields.
Apprehending yung mga walang face mask, walang face shield, and the proper use of face shield at saka face mask. Because we received approved ordinance from the Sangguniang Bayan, yung wearing of face shield now is to be implemented. First offense is 500, the penalty. Second offense, 1-5, then 2-5 yung third offense.
The governor of Benguet has also ordered the investigation on how the UK variant may have been transmitted.
Kasi ganito rin yung nangyari dito sa may Trinidad, sa may poblasyon Trinidad. Actually, wala din naman silang contact abroad. Or might be, may mga galing doon sa Mountain Province, in sa Bontoc particularly, kasi doon may contact yun from abroad.
Some residents in the north can't help but express concern, especially since the virus has already affected tourism and their livelihood.
Siyempre, mas nakakatakot naman itong kabuhayan namin ngayon dahil dito kami umaasa. Parang sabi nga ng marami, hindi ka mamamatay sa COVID, mamamatay ka sa gutom.
Meanwhile, the Center for Health Development in Region 7 clarified that the case in Liloan, Cebu was not actually detected in the area.
So, in all honesty, hindi po yan ang pasyente nakauwi. Neither po yan umuwi dito.
Taga Liloan lang siya.
Opo, kasi ang kinunan po nila ng base ay yung home address yun na nakasulat po sa ating mga CIM.
We like to apologize to the province of Cebu. Hindi po tayo para mag-instigate nitong takot. Ngunit yun lang po talaga ang ating regular o kasama po dun sa pagre-report natin talaga because that's part of their case investigation po.
The Philippines logged less than 2,000 new COVID-19 cases on Monday, bringing the country's COVID-19 tally to almost 539,000. 52 more patients have succumbed to the illness, while 23 others have recovered. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.